Remember my video on how to read a journal article in 10 minutes or less? Well, scratch that. Now you can do the same thing in 3 minutes or less. Wait, how is it humanly possible to read and understand a scientific journal article in 3 minutes? Good question. It's not humanly possible, but a reading robot can. In fact, some research indicates that today's ChatGPT-powered bots can read better than humans. ChatGPT can also pass the bar exam to become a lawyer. Now, how much of this is hype and how much of it is real? Let's take a look. SciSpace is an end-to-end research platform that every academic should check out. Its ChatGPT-powered reading robot is called Copilot. To access it, go to typeset.io, and once there, you can activate Copilot in two ways. The first is to locate an article in SciSpace's database of over 270 million research papers. But today, we're investigating the topic of thermal sensation. Now, a quick search on that one term, thermal sensation, produces, let's see, what, 553 results? Scrolling down, you're going to see full-text versions of some articles that can be accessed directly through SciSpace, as well as their abstracts. And some results offer a 3-minute summary of the article. Search results can be further filtered by those that offer a free PDF download or are in open access journals. They can also be arranged by citation count. That's the number of times other articles and authors have cited this one. Citation count provides an indication of the article's importance or influence, if you will, in this field. The results can also be arranged by year, type, and topics. So, taking a look at this first result, we see the initials TLDR. That's an abbreviation for too long, didn't read. This actually is a one-sentence summary of the entire article, and it can help you quickly judge an article's relevance to your particular search. To activate Copilot, you simply click on the article's title. The chat box is auto-populated with common questions, such as, what are the key takeaways? What were the main research approaches, experimental approaches, and so on. You can also ask your own questions using natural language. For example, I'll ask, how does age affect thermal comfort? And the answer I receive is based upon ChatGPT's training, not only upon that article. Now, in the top toolbar, clicking on citations reveals other articles that have cited this one. And related papers, of course, brings up studies that are closely related to this one that we're looking at on thermal comfort. A second way to activate Copilot is to upload to your SciSpace library a PDF of any article that you want the robot to read for you. An article I'd like some help with is Gender Differences in Thermal Sensation and Skin Temperature Sensitivity Under Local Cooling. Now on the left, you see the full text of the article, and on the right, the Copilot box. Let's begin with the pre-populated question. What are the results of this paper? Copilot extracts the results and renders them in plain English. Copilot operates also in 13 languages. For example, Spanish, KS El Confort, Termico, excuse my Spanish. And the answer will also come back in Spanish. Another important function of Copilot is to answer any individual questions you may come up with. For example, I would like a clear definition of local cooling if I'm going to understand this article. So after typing in the question, what is local cooling? I'm provided an answer that is not found in the article. It's found in GPT's training. Let's ask an even more specific question. When is it best to use local cooling? Again, Copilot provides a plain language answer from its own training. Another key feature of Copilot is its ability to explain math, tables, figures in really any section of text. You simply click on Explain Math and Table, then highlight what you would like that plain language explanation of. As you can see, here's figure 3. That is a pictorial summary of the entire experiment. And that figure becomes a lot more useful when it's explained by Copilot. The explain function also works for math. As you can see here with Copilot's explanation of this particular formula in the article. And it also works for any portion of text that you highlight because you would like more explanation or study of it. Okay, now that I've read my first article on thermal comfort, I want to narrow my search. I want to narrow it down to gender differences when it comes to thermal comfort. And I want only articles in PDF form. And as you can see, here are the results. One key difference when reading an article on SciSpace's database is this very important proprietary trace function. Let's try it on this first result. Note that trace provides us with 18 related papers. You're also told that this particular article is cited in 9 other works and contains 10 references. Here's a paper about gender differences that's very much on topic for us. Clicking on it, my search expands to the right, where I'm now provided with 20 more related papers to that narrowed search. Continuing to click on papers continues to open up trace pages to the right as I expand my search and even make it more narrow. Finally, don't forget this handy cite function at the top. It will allow you to find the correct citation format of that particular article for the 8 major academic style guides. That's a real useful tool. Okay, there you go. SciSpace for Writers provides these very important tools for the academic researcher.